Everyone, today we will discuss a lesson for class 9th from Behive, and the name of the lesson is The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. A short introduction: this story is a science fiction story with background setting of 2157 in future. It is a comparative study of school in present and school in future. The whole story is set in future where there are no schools and no books. The story is written in the form of a diary by a sweet little girl named Margie. It is a very beautiful and interesting story. Okay. The theme of the story is set in future of education, and this is the imaginative story by a girl named Margie. Okay. As I already told you that the whole story is set in future where there are no schools, no books, nothing. Now the question here arises that how will children study then? The diagram below may give you some idea, so let's have a look on the diagram. Children will learn through computer. Children will attend virtual classroom. This means that children will be sitting at their home and studying and will study on computer. Children will understand and study from robotic teacher. Children will be learning and reading text by moving e-text. This means that everything will be available on a computer. Let us begin. We will read the story and I will explain the word meaning and the story as we go on. So let's get started. Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary on page headed 17th May 2157. She wrote, "Today Tommy found a real book." It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all the stories were printed on a paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly. Crinkly means scratched, and it was awful fun to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on screen, you know. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it and on it that it had when they read it the first time. Okay. Now the story takes place in 2157 in future. That means 137 years after. The main character of the story is Margie. We can say that the whole story revolves around the Margie. She is 11 years old and she has a habit of writing a diary. So on 17th May 2157, she wrote a diary. And in that she wrote that today Tommy found a real book. She experienced it strange because at her time there are no such kind of books as they study through computer. The book which Tommy found was very old book. After seeing book, Margie remembers of her grandfather's word, as her grandfather told her that when he was a child, his grandfather told him that all the stories were printed on a paper. This means at present, we are talking about our present time in which books are printed on paper. But for Margie, these books is sort of a history which they cannot touch, but they can believe and which they can hear from their grandfather and their fathers. Margie is talking about the book which Tommy has found. She said that the pages of the book had turned yellow and are totally crushed. It was a fun for children to read books in which words are stable and words do not move. But what happened in ebook is that as you move your screen, words also starts moving, and books which Margie and Tommy were reading were online, and it was totally a new experience for them. He said, "Tommy, what a waste. When you are through the book, you will just throw it away. I guess our television screen must have had millions of books on it. And it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away." Okay, so in the stanza, Tommy, we can say that Tommy totally disliked the printed books and said, "What a waste!" Because after reading the book, we can throw it away. On the printed books, you cannot have different words or stories written on same page. He is comparing ebook with the printed book and said that the same screen shows us plenty of books and we cannot throw that ebook after reading it once. Our television screen has million of books, which is very good, and we can not throw it away. Okay, same with mine, said Margie. She was 11 and had not seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. He was 13. Okay, Margie said that my television screen is also like yours. I have read many books on it and I can read many more. Tommy is 13 years old here. Okay, she said, where did you find it? In my house, he pointed without looking because he was busy reading in the attic. Attic means a space just below the roof, used as a storeroom. Okay, so Margie asked, where did you find this book? Tommy replied, in my house, without looking at Margie, in the storeroom. Margie questioned, what's it about? Margie questioned, like, what kind of book it is? So he told her that it's a school book. Okay. Margie was scornful. School? What's there to write about school? I hate school. Margie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and went to the county inspector. Okay, now Margie hated word school, so she said that what is there to write about school? Further, we will come to know why Margie hated school. Margie's school is a mechanical teacher. That means machine teaches her, not the school where we go, not the teacher from whom we study at the present time. Why she hates school? Because her school was a virtual classroom. It wasn't a real classroom, which we have today. Margie hated this mechanical teacher because this mechanical teacher was giving test after test and Margie was not doing good in that test. That's why she hated the mechanical teacher. Finally, her mother thought that there is something wrong. That there is something wrong with the mechanical teacher. And she called the county inspector to check the machine. He was a round little man with red face and whole box of tools with dials and wires. He smiled at Margie and gave her an apple. Then he took the teacher apart. Margie had hoped he would not know how to put it together again, but he knew how, all right. And after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with big screen on which all the lessons were shown and questions were asked. That wasn't so bad. The part Margie hated most was the slot where she had to put homework and test paper. She always had to write them out in a punch code. Punch code means, we can say that in a computer language. They made her learn when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. Okay. Now, county inspector came to check the machine. He was round little man with red face. He opened the machine and took it apart. When he opened the computer, Margie wished that he would not be able to close the machine or mechanical teacher again, because she did not like the mechanical teacher and did not like to study from that mechanical teacher. But after some time, the county master was back with the machine. Margie here gives the description of the machine. It was large, ugly and black, with large screen on which all the lessons and questions were asked. Okay, the part which Margie hated the most was homework slot. Slot means a given space in which she has to put the test paper or the homework. Okay. And the worst over that was she has to write that homework or a paper or a test paper into a computer language. Okay. And when she put that test on in the slot, within a time, computer teacher or a mechanical teacher, we can say, that calculates the marks in no time. Okay, the inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Margie's head. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Johns. I think the geography sector was geared little quick. Those things happen sometime. I have sold it up to an average 10-year level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Margie's head again. Margie was disappointed she had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. So she said to Tommy, why would anyone write about school? Okay. So county inspector told the mother that she was getting less marks in geography, but it was not Margie's fault. The machine was not working properly. It was geared up for upper level. These such thing happens sometimes. Now I have solved down the problem and I have geared it up to the level of 10 years old girl. He said the way Margie learns is very good, and he again patted Margie's head. Margie was totally sad after seeing the mechanical teacher because she didn't like the mechanical teacher. She was thinking that she was thinking that county inspector will take the teacher away. Margie is recollecting the time when Tommy's mechanical teacher was not working properly and the whole history section was totally cleared up, and the county inspector took the mechanical teacher along with him for 1 month. Now we come to know why Margie hated school, and she had asked Tommy such a question like, why would anyone write about the school? Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it's not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had 100 years of ago, that means at present time. He added loftily means in a superior way, pronouncing word carefully, "Centuries ago." Margie was hurt. "Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all that time ago." She read the book over her shoulder for a while, then said, "Anyway, they had a teacher." Okay, now what happens? Now Tommy was looking towards Margie with superior eyes because he knew something which Margie didn't know, and said Margie was silly because she didn't know that 100 years of ago the school was not the kind they had. And further, Tommy wants to focus on the word century ago. That is why he used the word lofty. Margie was hurt with Tommy's behavior and said she didn't know school were like this 100 years ago. She got queries and wanted to know what kind of school were centuries ago. She said they may had a teacher. She said that they may have a teacher. Replied Tommy, "Sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man." "A man? How could a man be a teacher?" Well, he just told the boys and girls things to give the things and gave them homework and asked them questions. Regular means normal. Tommy replied, "It was not a regular teacher," referring to machine which they have. He said that it was a man. Marky surprised. A man? How can man be teacher? She said only she had seen only machine as a teacher, only computer as a teacher. Tommy told that man teaching in the classroom discussed many things with students, gave homework and asked different questions based upon the information or based upon the chapter. Okay. A man isn't smart enough. Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as much a bicha. Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I don't want a strange man in my house to teach me. Tommy screamed with laughter. You don't know much, Margie. The teacher don't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids learned same thing. Sure, if they were the same age. Bicha means I'm sure. Means to give surety. Disputes means disagree. Okay. Margie said that the man teaching a student, it's not as smart as a computer teacher. Tommy replied, he didn't understand the human teacher is as intelligent as a computer teacher. Compared the machine with the father and said that my father knew as much as computer teacher knew about the lessons or subject. Bicha. Tommy says he can bet and says human teachers know as much as the computer teacher or a mechanical teacher know. Margie don't want to have fight over it, but she said that she didn't want to have a strange man in her house to teach her. Okay. After hearing the words from Margie, Tommy laughed and told her that teachers don't live in the house. He said they live in a special building named school and all students go there. Margie was like totally surprised and asked, "Did all the children study the same thing?" Tommy replied, "If they are of same age." Okay. "But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and a girl it teaches and that each kid has to be taught differently. But the same, they don't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. I did not say I did not like it. Margie said quickly. She wanted to read about those funny schools. They weren't even half finished when Margie's mother called, "Margie, school." Margie looked up. "Not yet, Mama." "Now," said Mrs. Johns. "And it's probably time for Tommy too," Margie said to Tommy. "Can I read the book some more with you after school?" Okay, here Margie is referring to machine teacher. She said that her mother told that the machine teacher has to be tuned according to the kid's mind because the machine doesn't know the capability of the individual child. Tommy said that if you don't like it, then don't read the book. Tommy was irritated because Margie was trying to take the book with her. And the information and together the information given in the book about the past. Margie is interested in books. She requires to know what kind of school were there in the past. This means in our present. Margie was excited. She wanted to know what kind of schools were there in past. The book was not half complete. Margie's mother called her for the school. Margie, school was in next room, she said. She don't want to go to school right now. In the harsh voice, Mrs. John said, now, Tommy will also go to school too. Now Margie is so interested in reading the book. Then she asked Tommy, can she read book with him after the school? Maybe, he said nonchalantly. He walked away whistling the dusty old book tucked beneath his arms. Margie went into classroom. It was right next to her bedroom and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday. Nonchalantly means not showing any kind of interest, he doesn't want to read book with Margie. Okay. Tommy replied, maybe, and he was feeling very great because Margie was interested in reading a book. He placed the book under his arms and walked towards his home. Margie has reached her school. It is a room next to her room. It was a machine who will teach her. Tommy replied, and he was feeling very great because Margie was interested in reading a book. He placed the book under his arms and walked towards his home. Margie has reached his school, which is next to her bedroom. It was a virtual classroom. The machine was on and was waiting for her. And was waiting for her to start teaching her. Except Saturday and Sunday, the machine teacher was open at same time. We can say that Margie studied at the same time from Monday to Friday on a computer teacher. Okay. Because her mother said, little girl learn better if they learn at a regular hour. The screen was lit up and it said, today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fraction. Please insert yesterday's homework on the slot. Okay. Margie's mother was very much particular about Margie's study. She said that she will learn better if she study every day at same time. The screen of the computer teacher was open. The lesson for the day is in mathematics. The topic is fraction. The computer teacher gave the instructions to Margie to insert the homework in the homework slot. Okay. Margie did so with a sigh. She was thinking about all schools they had when her grandfather's father was a little boy. All the kids from the school, from the whole neighborhood, came laughing and shouting in a schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. They learned the same thing so they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. And the teachers were people. The mechanical teachers were flashing on screen when we add fraction 1 by 2, and Margie was thinking about how the kid must have loved it in the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had. Okay. Margie's life is like a mechanical teacher. No fun, nothing else. Margie is thinking about this story told by her grandfather. A grandfather told her that his grandfather goes to school when he was a little boy. This is the life you all are living at present, but this is the life you are living at present, but for Margie, but in future the kids won't be able to enjoy all these stuff as we are enjoying in the present. Okay, so this is about the lesson, and in the end I would like to give you the message from the story. The message of the story is that the real education is about providing adequate and right environment for learning. The writer warns against future education system which may become completely digital and computerized with zero social interaction and thus may prove fatal to the healthy education system. The title Fun They Had also conveyed the message that learning process must be a fun and should take place in a healthy and a congenial environment. Thanks for watching my video. Like, share, comment and subscribe.